In this video, we are going to discuss static error constants. So here, when a control system is excited with a constant input or standard input signal, that means excitation means giving input. So when a control system is excited with a standard input signal, then the steady state error may be 0. Steady state error means there is a mismatch between exact output and input. So that mismatch, the difference between input and output, we will consider like an error signal. So here the steady state error may be 0 or constant or infinite. That is dependent upon the value of steady state error, depends upon the type number and input signal. So we already discussed what is meant by type number. Type number is nothing but number of poles at the origin will decide the type number of the system. So here, whatever the control system we are exciting with a standard input signal, so that may have steady state error as 0 or constant or infinite. That steady state error will depends upon the type number of the system or the input signal. These are three types. The static error constants are three types. So here, positional error constant, so always we will call that positional error constant as Kp. So Kp is equivalent to, the formula to calculate Kp is equivalent to limit s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. Velocity error constant Kv, so limit s tends to 0 s into g of s into h of s. Like that, acceleration error constant Ka, so that is equivalent to limit s tends to 0 s square into g of s into h of s. These are the formulas to calculate the static error constant. So whenever we are getting that steady state error, the static error constants we need to calculate. That static error constants can be depends upon the type number of the system. So here we are having three static error constants: positional, velocity and acceleration. So each will represent with Kp, Kv and Ka respectively. The general formula for positional error constant is limit s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. For velocity, we need to add one other s, that means we need to multiply ns. So here we need to multiply another s, that means we need to make that as s square. These three formulas are very important in so many problems to calculate the static error constants. In further videos, we are going to use these formulas. So that's why please keep in mind about positional error constant, velocity error constant and acceleration error constant, and where Kp, Kv, Ka are static error constants. According to the type number of the system and input signal, we are going to derive, or we are going to calculate these static error constants.